So is a Mac Mini from 2014 still usable as a computer in 2024? Well, I ended up buying one and did some real-world tests and some benchmarks. And let's find out together if a late 2014 Mac Mini is usable today, and if yes, then to what extent. Well, first, to clear things up, the Mac Mini I have, as I said, is a late 2014 model with the model identifier Mac Mini 7,1 with a dual core Intel Core i5-4278U running at a base clock of 2.6 GHz with onboard Intel Iris graphics, which is what you can call the mid-range CPU configuration for this model of Mac Mini. The base model being a 1.4 GHz dual core Intel Core i5, and the model I got here with the 2.6 GHz i5 and two other more powerful CPUs, these being a 2.8 GHz i5 or a 3 GHz i7. So before you consider buying a 2014 Mac Mini, you should look at all the mentioned CPU configurations you can get. I'd advise you from buying the base model with the 1.4 GHz i5. There probably isn't a huge difference in price between that one and the 2.6 GHz one I got, and the performance will be a lot better. When it comes to RAM, mine's got 8 GB of 1600 MHz LPDDR3 memory. You could also find this Mac Mini with 16 GB of RAM. But an important reminder is that the RAM in this Mac Mini is soldered onto the logic board, meaning it's not user upgradable and requires expensive equipment and soldering skills to replace. So if you're going to buy this Mac Mini, note that the amount of RAM that you will get will be all you have to work with. For storage, my Mac Mini has a 256 GB M.2 SSD from the factory. Different configurations can have a hard drive or a hybrid so-called fusion drive of varying capacities. Unlike the memory, the storage can be upgraded. There is a space for a 2.5-inch laptop style drive, which requires taking the logic board out to access, and a proprietary M.2 SSD slot, which is easier to access, and with the use of an adapter, you can use any M.2 SSD. My recommendation here is that you should definitely get one with a solid state drive or upgrade in one, because the difference between a hard drive and an SSD is huge and will make this Mac Mini feel a lot faster. If you're curious, the speeds I'm getting from the original Apple SSD this Mac Mini has, well, here they are. 717 MB a second write and 699 MB a second read. Moving over to the I/O, the late 2014 Mac Mini has two Thunderbolt 2 ports up to 20 gigabits per second. Note this is the older style Thunderbolt 2 and not the newer Thunderbolt 3 with the USB-C connector. The Thunderbolt ports can be used for DisplayPort video output. I tested it and it can drive a 1080p display at 165Hz. According to Apple's specification, it should support 4K as well, although at a significantly lower refresh rate. Besides Thunderbolt, it has 4 USB 3 ports up to 5 gigabits per second, an HDMI port up to a resolution of 4096 by 2160 at 24Hz, gigabit Ethernet, SDXC card reader, line in, and a headphone jack, something you don't see very often anymore, especially on Apple's newer mobile devices. It also has an IR receiver for use with compatible remotes. For wireless capabilities, it has 802.11ac Wi-Fi and Bluetooth 4.0. So with all the many configurations and specifications mentioned, how does this Mac Mini perform? Well, about as good as you'd expect for a 2014 Mac Mini. I got a Geekbench CPU score of 962 for a single core and 1868 for a multi-core score. The onboard Intel Iris graphics got a GPU score of 4460 in Geekbench. Then I ran Cinebench and got a single core result of 684 and a multi-core result of 1669. Nice. Keep in mind that all the testing I've done on this Mac Mini was done in macOS 14.5 Sonoma, which is officially not supported on this Mac Mini. The macOS this late 2014 Mac Mini will officially run is macOS 12 Monterey, but thanks to OpenCore Legacy Patcher, it can run the latest macOS without a problem. If you want to know more about OpenCore and how you can use it, I will leave a link to the official guide from OpenCore in the description. Aside from benchmark scores, this Mac Mini does quite well under regular everyday use, like web browsing, streaming video, and using a word processor. Video editing with iMovie or Final Cut does work if you're willing to stick to 1080p. It really can't handle 4K video editing. If you want 4K editing, consider getting a newer Mac or a Mac with a better GPU. Just keep in mind that this Mac Mini only has a dual core processor, which is not a lot of cores by today's standard, and it does show that it's struggling when multitasking and applications that would benefit from multiple cores will be slower to use than with a CPU that has more cores. But does it game? Well, first of all, if you want to pick this Mac Mini up for gaming, then just please don't. Get a used PC at the same price point or build one yourself. It will be way better in performance and run Windows, because macOS has a lackluster support for games. Just as an example, out of the 131 games I had in my Steam library, only 17 of them can run on macOS, and this doesn't guarantee they will run at a playable FPS or anything, just the fact that they run at all. Well, you might be asking, why not install Windows through Bootcamp? Just like I said earlier, just get a PC instead. It's not worth the effort installing Windows on this thing just to be able to game. If you want to buy this Mac Mini, buy it as a Mac for office and productivity use, for using Apple's set of software not available on PC, for Macs being known for being reliable but not for gaming. But if you want to stream games, it is quite good. For example, you have a gaming PC at home and let's say you want to play your games on the TV downstairs, then just hook up this Mac Mini to your living room TV, set up Steam Link, making sure the computer you want to stream from and your Mac Mini is connected wired through Ethernet, and then it will work perfectly for streaming games. Just do not consider this Mac Mini if you want to play games natively. Let's say you're crazy enough to game on a Mac. How will this Mac Mini perform? Well, I tested it so you don't have to, and here are the results I got. The first game I tried was Rocket League. which was not a great start. The game would not launch from the Steam library. I tried launching it manually from its .app application file, which is an application in macOS similar to an exe in Windows. That gave me an error saying that the application may be damaged or incomplete even after I verified the integrity of the game. Even going into the package contents and trying to launch the Unix executable in terminal did not work. Well, let's try something I know will work. Doki Doki Literature Club. Yep, so I tried DDLC+ because if it can run that, then that means it can run regular DDLC without a hitch. And yeah, DDLC+ works perfectly fine. Well, maybe I went a little too easy. Alright, let's try Minecraft, because after a day of thinking, I really couldn't think of any other game to try that would be worth trying. Minecraft runs about okay, with the graphics setting set to fast, running Minecraft 1.20.4 with Optifine, the FPS fluctuated all over the place, from as low as 30 FPS going as high as 100 FPS. And even when the game was averaging around 60 FPS, it seemed laggy. But then I tried turning on the smooth FPS in the performance settings, and that actually removed the lag. The FPS was now comfortably averaging at 60 without the spikes and dips from earlier. And you know what? I would consider this playable. So yeah, this late 2014 Mac Mini can run Minecraft. Just lower the graphics a little and turn on smooth FPS in the settings if the game feels laggy. To summarize everything, should you buy this late 2014 Mac Mini? If you want to get yourself a Mac for under 200 euros to use in everyday tasks like web browsing, audio and video production, coding and some light gaming, then yes, this Mac Mini will be able to do all of those things and maybe a little more. But suppose you're a power user and want to do 4K video editing or 3D rendering or any other graphically intensive production, or you want to play the latest games at high settings, in that case, you should probably be looking for something more powerful, which in turn would be more expensive. But this Mac Mini does give quite good of a performance for its price and is one of the best Mac computers you can get at this price point. With that said, thanks for watching this video. It would be very kind if you would subscribe if you found this video helpful, and maybe share it with people you know who might be interested in getting a Mac. Mata ne.